FC Goa shook off a day-long ordeal to play out a valiant 1-1 draw against defending champions RTK in a delayed Indian Super League match that got away well past midnight under unforeseen circumstances at the Salt Lake Stadium, here. In a first in Indian football and in one of the rarest instances, the match kicked off at 10:45 p.m. in peak winter after a day-long drama surrounding FC Goa team's arrival. The Goan team's arrival got delayed following technical snag to their chartered flight and later due to crash of a fighter jet at the Dabolim airport that forced the closure of the runway. To make matters worse for the visitors, Captain Robbie Keane headed home from Ryan Taylor's angled free kick to give RTK the lead against the fatigued Goans in less than 4 minutes. The Goans were quick to bounce back to restore parity in the 24th minute when Spanish forward Ferran Coromina surged past Ashutosh Mehta and rounded off RTK goalkeeper Debjit Majumdar en route to his 9th ISL goal. The visitors then went on to dominate the pitch and nearly got a 39th-minute penalty when Brandon Fernandes was brought down by Prabir Das inside the box, but referee Shri Kirishna thought otherwise. Goa once again got a fine opportunity in the 73rd minute as Coromina's latched onto the ball from a throw-in to set up Mandar Rao Desai, whose right-footed shot was easily cleared away as both teams shared the spoils. It was Goa's maiden draw of the season, a creditable result under the circumstances, to move up to 4th spot ahead of Mumbai City FC on goal difference, while RTK remained on 7th. A fuming FC Goa head coach Sergio Lobera was furious with the organizers for conducting the late night match. "I have never faced such a situation in professional football. ISL is a great league and it does not deserve matches like today," Lobera said after the match. "It's not a good spectacle. We spent the entire day at the airport with nothing to eat and nowhere to rest. And we had to come here running, as otherwise, we would have lost 3 points," he lamented. FC Goa's chartered flight finally took off at 6:30 p.m. after getting the necessary clearance and landed around 9 p.m. at the Dum Dum airport, from where they headed straight to the Salt Lake Stadium. A few thousand anxious fans kept on waiting while RTK were going through their paces when the Sergio Lobera coached side entered the pitch at 9:45 p.m. But there was more drama in store as they turned up in casual gear of red t-shirts and black shorts as their team kit had not arrived. FC Goa team management held intense discussions with the match commissioner before the players huddled up and went about their drills. In the evening, the organizers had stated in a release that the match will be delayed by a minimum 1 hour due to unavoidable circumstances. But what transpired on the field was a series of delays, beginning with a 9:30 p.m. announcement. There was speculation of a cancellation before the national anthem was played at 10:40 p.m. and the match finally kicked off after a delay of 2 hours and 45 minutes. There has been one instance in La Liga when Barcelona had played their home match against Sevilla 5 minutes past midnight in September 2003.